this new religion, they forgot and they contradict these oaths they have pronounced face to the Holy Sacrament, and they sign many times in their lives. And this is a very great sin.
You can sit down.
Of the divine nature and of the very life of God is called the sanctifying grace. This grace, this gift, makes us just at the eyes of God, and in the same time is in some way our deification. God makes us little gods, his sons. In the Psalms, God says, I have said, you are gods, and the sons of the Most High. If we are the sons of God, then we are gods by adoption. And this is a big miracle. This miracle, to make us really sons of God, is the biggest miracle of God. Bigger than that the creation of the universe, says Saint Thomas. In this way, God transforms us, transforms a poor sinner in a son of God, whose destiny will be to live for all the eternity in the intimacy of God. And the person who is the part of this sanctification, of this transformation of the sinners in sons of God, is the Holy Ghost. Such is the justification, the masterwork of the power of God. Saint Augustine said, to justify a sinner is a major thing than to create the earth and the heaven. Because the earth and the heaven will pass, but the justification and the salvation of the predestinated will not pass, forever, will not pass. That is why we must always be grateful to our Father and to our Lord Jesus Christ for this gift he gave us on the cross, where he gave us to our Blessed Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, the devil knew this intention of God to make us sons of God, gods. And that is why he told to Adam and Eva, with the absolute freedom to tell what is good and what is bad, to decide you, yourself, you will be like gods. You will be gods. But only God can do that in the way he chose himself. If we are good, if we believe in the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, if we keep the faith, the Catholic faith, so as the Son of God is the Word of God, the Verb, so the Holy Ghost is the love of God. Saint Paul writes to the Romans, the love of God has filled up our hearts with the Holy Ghost that was given to us. Our Lord told the Samaritan, the true adorator, is an invisible manner. But there are signs you can see or you can hear. In the same moment, they came with the grace. And so when the Holy Ghost, who is the first gift of God to the faithful, came, he came in an invisible manner in the people, but in a visible manner by a big wind and by some flames, little fire on the head of the Blessed Virgin Mary and the Apostles. And then you see the transformation of the Apostles. The Apostles believe in that time in our Lord, but they do not go out to convert people, because they were afraid. They had not the courage to do it. But after the coming of the Holy Ghost, they are full of courage, full of the love of God, of the truth. And they go out and they spoke to many peoples about the divinity of our Lord, about his resurrection, about the eternal life, and about the good examples of our Lord that we have to follow, because they are the orders of our Lord to live as sons of God, to be good. And so the apostles convert hundreds and thousands of people in Jerusalem to begin. And that was the beginning of the church. And after they went all around the Mediterranean Sea and they convert all these cities. They had groups of faithful. In the beginning, there was not very large groups. There are little groups, as you are, as we are. But that was the seed of the Catholic Church. And they go to the capital of the empire in Rome. And they convert people in Rome. And within two centuries, on the third century, the imperator of Rome was converted to the Christianism. And so the apostles, we were poor. Fishermen could conquer all the Roman Empire. Why? Because they had the Holy Ghost in them. The Holy Ghost is the love of the Father and of the Son. The substantial love of the Father and of the Son. And he is the third person of the Holy Trinity. He is the love of God. And that's why all the works of God are the works of the Holy Ghost. When God creates the universe and the man, it was by love, because God is love, is charity. When he redeems the sinners, it was love, by love. When he sanctifies the faithful and the apostles, it's by love. When he glorifies the Son of God, it's love. And so all the works of God are the works of the Holy Ghost, of love, of the love of God. And that is why it is very important to receive the Holy Ghost. Of course, you have received the Holy Ghost with the baptism, because our Lord told to the apostles, you will baptize all people in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And in the baptism, you receive the Holy Ghost. But now, in the confirmation, you will receive him in a very special manner, much more important. And that is why it's one of the seven sacraments, very important to be good Christians. Because to be Christians always has been a fight. Big fight. The first Christians in the beginning of the history of the church, when they were arrested, they lead them to the lions and to the cross and to the fire, and there were thousands and thousands of martyrs. But they confess the truth of the divinity of our Lord till the end, till the death. In the middle of big sufferings, tortures, what gave them this strength to be good, to give a testimony of the truth of the faith? It is the Holy Ghost. And it is very important. Maybe one day we'll have some revolution from war, a war. We don't know. And as we are now few Catholics, maybe they will say, or you abandon the Catholicism, or we shall kill you. And then we shall need the strength of the Holy Ghost to accept to die and to suffer to stay as Catholics. It has been always in the history of the Church, there has been thousands and thousands of martyrs. And that may occur today. And we saw many signs that it may occur. So you will necessitate much strength, and this strength is what you receive now in the sacrament of confirmation. To receive this sacrament, it is to transform us in soldiers of Christ, till the death. See, it is necessary. The Holy Ghost is the first gift of God to us, the most important. And all the other gifts, we receive them by the Holy Ghost. And it is why the Holy Ghost will give you gifts, seven gifts, to enlighten your mind, to understand the situation in which we are, where the world is in the victory, apparent victory, and the enemies of God have infiltrated the Church of God. And so the faithful needs to understand that. But this is a grace, a light of God, of the Holy Ghost. And after, you need the strength, the character, to say, I shall not accept that. I shall stay Catholic as were my parents, my grandparents, my ancestors, since the beginning, since 2000 years, the Catholicism has been concerned for 2000 years in the Church by 215 popes. And this is the real religion. It is the Church of always, the religion of always. But as you know, since 50 years, there was a false council in Rome, and with this council, they want to give us a new religion. If you go to a modernist church, you will see immediately that it is a false religion. It is not the religion of always. The people who are old, as I am, we have been taught the Catholicism in our Catholic church and Catholic schools. And after the revolution of the Council Vatican II, we did not recognize this religion. It was not the same religion they had taught to us. Our fathers, our priests, taught us a very different religion. In the true religion, they speak quite a lot of God, of our Lord, of the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the new religion, they speak quite a lot of man, of the freedom of man, of the rights of man. But these are Masonic ideas. With these Masonic ideas, freedom, equality, liberty, they destroy the old Catholic society, and now with the same ideas, they are destroying the church. So we must resist. And to resist to this river, we have to swim against, and it is very difficult. But with the help of God, we shall do it. And so we need to the help of the Blessed Virgin Mary. She is the guardian of the faith, of our religion. And she will help us to keep faithful till the end. Our Lord told in the Gospel, when I shall come back to earth, maybe I shall not encounter faith. Only very few people will be with faith. Only the ones that will keep faithful to the doctrine of the faith, to the catechism, only him will be saved. That means the other, those who accept the general apostasy, won't be saved. So it's a duty for us to keep Catholics with our books, our catechism, the books of Archbishop Lefebvre, and all the books of all saints. Our religion, our mass, are the mass and the religion of the saints, of all the great saints of 2,000 years in the church, and of all the popes. So we cannot be wrong. That is the truth, because the Holy Ghost was with his church, with these good popes, and with all the saints, he has been for 2,000 years. And so we are sure we are not wrong. We are Catholics, and we want to remain Catholics till the end. God bless you. God bless you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.